This video was brought to you by Dollar Shave Club. Get top quality razors delivered to your door starting at just $1 a month. Link below in the description. Skip it up and that up.
So the Xbox One is getting a temporary price cut in the US. The deal, which starts November 2nd, will see the Xbox One go to $349 over the holidays. The $50 saving also extends across a range of bundles, including the upcoming additions for Assassin's Creed Unity, Sunset Overdrive, and Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Fans don't have to wait for Black Friday this year to enjoy great savings on Xbox One, Yusuf Mede said, corporate vice president of Microsoft. We're offering our best price yet, with unprecedented choices and value, so more people can play on Xbox One this holiday. We're gearing up for one of our biggest holidays ever, and we are thrilled to offer fans up to $150 in savings on Xbox One and some of the biggest blockbuster games of the season. The deal ends January 3rd, 2015. Okay, so someone needs to fill me in here as to why this is a bad thing. If you look on YouTube or in gaming groups on Facebook, you see people saying all over, Xbox One isn't selling well, that's why the price has to be cut exposed. Microsoft is exposed for a bad console. $349 already, Microsoft, you are so exposed, exposed. I'm exposing myself while saying exposed. Oh. Well, I have something to say to all you guys putting those comments up and putting the videos up hating on Microsoft for cutting the price. You want Shuhei Yoshida to sit on your face. Exposed. I don't understand how this is a bad thing. I think it's brilliant. It's a temporary price cut for the holiday season, but I think it's a very smart idea. They know the Xbox One isn't selling as well as the PS4, and they're trying to entice more people to buy the console by making it more affordable. How dare Microsoft do that? I don't get it. It's a smart move. They're being aggressive. What is so bad about them cutting the price? Please, if I'm missing something, by all means, let me know. But you know what's funny, though, is that a lot of people talking shit about this. Most of you, if Microsoft didn't change the price of the Xbox One at all, they didn't make a Kinectless bundle, and you could only still get the Xbox One for $499 with the Kinect, you'd be ripping them a new asshole for that too, so they can't win either way. Look, I get it. Microsoft fucked up the launch of the Xbox One. I've talked about it numerous times before, and I wholeheartedly agree with you. But they're trying to remedy things. They're trying to turn things around. They're being aggressive with the marketing and the pricing. Yeah, okay, they made mistakes, but they're trying to fix them. What is the big fucking deal? And to all the people who are angry because, hey, I bought an Xbox One at launch for $500. I feel like I got robbed. Welcome to getting a console when it first comes out. It's happened a billion times in the past before, and if there is another console launch in the future, if there are 9th-gen consoles, it'll probably happen again. You were an early adopter. You were the guinea pig. Yes, you spent extra money, but guess what? That's how it goes. So from now on in the future, realize if you buy a console at launch, it may drop in price, maybe even a couple months later, and you may feel robbed. That's what it is. If you want to be an early adopter, that's a risk you take. You're going to have to deal with it. All right, folks, this is Rich of Review Tech USA. Make sure to rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe. And as always, thank you for supporting my channel. Have a good one.